In today's video, we're going to talk about accessibility testing using in Cypress automation testing. So accessibility testing is an important aspect of web and software development to ensure that digital products are usable by people with disabilities. Web content accessibility guidelines. These are guidelines that provide a set of criteria and success criteria for making web content more accessible. Axe is a popular accessibility testing tool that automates the process of identifying and reporting accessibility issues on web pages. So here are some tips for running accessibility testing. First, you have to install cypress-axe. So in order to install cypress-axe as a dev dependency in your project, you use this command right here. The second thing you have to do is you have to configure cypress-axe in Cypress. And so in order to do this, what you'll first do is you'll open your support file and you'll add this line of code. The third thing you have to do is write accessibility tests using cypress-axe. And so in your test files, you can now use cypress-axe commands to inject and run axe accessibility checks. The two main commands are cypress.injectAxe and cypress.checka11y. So these are two main commands. And so cypress.injectAxe, this injects the Cypress accessibility testing library into the page. And this, on the other hand, runs the axe accessibility test and reports any issues found. Next, running accessibility test checks on specific elements. So you can narrow the accessibility checks to specific parts of the page, which can be useful for large pages or testing specific components. And this is an example of doing that. So you will get your main content, and then on your main content, you perform check.a11y. You can also customize accessibility checks with options. You can customize this by specifying axe options, specific impact levels, or excluding certain rules. And this is an example of doing that. You can also add assertions for accessibility violations. To automatically fail test when accessibility violations are detected, use cy.checka11y directly or add custom insertions for finer control. Some additional tips that we have for running accessibility tests are: run accessibility checks on key pages or components. Focus on main user flows or key components to make the testing more efficient. Integrate accessibility tests in CI. Automate accessibility tests and checks in your continuous integration pipeline to catch issues early. Review and address violations. Regularly review and fix accessibility violations to improve overall user experience. Using cypress-axe for accessibility testing in Cypress provides a powerful way to ensure that your application complies with accessibility standards. By integrating these checks into your test suite, you can catch and address accessibility issues early, making your application more accessible to all users. So now I'm going to show you how you can add accessibility testing into your own project. So right here we have something open. And the first thing we're going to do under this project is we're going to install the axe package. So go ahead and write this into your axe command. So I'm going to write npm install cypress-axe. So give it some time. So let me try that again. npm install cypress-axe like that. And so this might take a while. So I'm going to pause the video now and come and get back to you. And there we go. So it finished installing successfully. And now I'm going to go ahead and continue with the rest of the steps. So the first thing I'm going to go is I'm going to go under support. I'm going to go to E2E, and now I'm actually going to import the command so that we can use the axe. And so what I'm going to do is under this import.commands, I'm going to write import cypress-axe. There we go. and go ahead and save this. And now I can go ahead and write my own accessibility test. So within my scripts folder, I'm going to create a new script. And I'm going to name it accessibility .js. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start writing the script. So first, let's go ahead and do describe. And how am I going to describe this? Well, I'm going to write accessibility testing with cypress-axe. And I'm going to write a before each function. And what this will do is this will make it so that it runs this before every time a function is ran. And so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to visit a website. And in this case, we're going to use Google. And so this is being a little bit dot visit https.ca. And so this will help us visit Google. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to inject Axe. And so what this does is this begins accessibility testing. And now we can write each individual function. And so let's begin with our first function. And we'll use this command IT. IT dot and then IT, and this will be should have no detectable accessibility violations. And so this one will be basically what we're going to do is we're going to test the accessibility test on google.com. And so since Google is very, very well optimized, there should be no problem with accessibilities on Google. And so I'm going to go ahead and create that. So I'm going to do site.log and then site.check a11y that, and then we'll run accessibility checks on Google. Now, the second one we're going to do is we're going to run accessibility checks on a few other websites. Let's define our function, and this will be filtering accessibility spell issues by impact level. And so this will be site.log, site.check a11y, and now this will perform accessibility checks, and we're going to have pass null. And then what we'll do is this, and we'll do included impacts, and then we have it like that, and then we have critical, be passing critical, and we'll leave it like this. And so what this does is this runs accessibility check on the entire page, and it'll basically filter by impact level. So this is both for google.com so far. And now what we can do is we can perform accessibility checks on specific parts of a web page. And so what we can do is we can do should check specific section for A11y violations. And so let's do that. Side.get. And this is dot dash select, or just dot select, dot then. So using the select, we're going to perform some accessibility checks on this. So side.log, side.check A11y, select on the select element. And we'll basically run accessibility checks on this. Next, we will do some more accessibility checks. So what we're going to do is we're going to run accessibility checks without failing the test. And so let me write another one. So should log all violations without failing the test. And so what we have is we'll do psi.check, A11, null, null. And what we'll do is basically violations. This will pass in violations. We'll say that violations dot for each. A violation will basically do psi.log. And then what we'll do is we'll pass in dot impact. We'll do this dot impact. Dot impact is this. And this is v dot description. Description, and a tilde, and notice that this is a tilde, not a quotation mark, and then we'll do that. And so this should handle each violation without failing the task. So now I'm going to go ahead and save this. And in order to run this, I will basically use my command npx cypress open. Allow that. Go ahead and go E2E testing. I'll select Chrome and give it some time. And then I'll go down to my test that I ran. So it's under my scripts accessibility. And it'll go through each of the tests individually. And so we begin, and we'll go through each of these individually. So it's done running all four of these tests, and we see some errors, so we'll go through each of these individually. So right here for our first test, we expected no accessibility issues with Google. But what we found was when we ran accessibility test on Google, so we basically went to Google, we performed the accessibility test, we actually found 5 accessibility violations with Google. And that's something that we found. The second thing what we did was, again, we went to Google. And again, what we did was we basically let me open this up. What we did, the second one was we filter accessibility issues by impact level right here and right here. And then we found that when we filtered for critical impact levels, we didn't find any critical violations in this one. So in this one, what we did was we filtered for critical ones. Now in the third one, what we did was we went to a specific section to look for a violation. And so let's see, in the third one, we went to right here. We found a specific section, select, which is something on the page. And then we found that the element select was actually not found. And so this is actually something that is interesting. So I'm going to look at this again, but let's look at the fourth one first. The fourth one, we were basically logging all the accessibility issues right here. And it shouldn't fail the test after each issue. So let me open this up. And again, it's going through the 5. It found 5 accessibility violations, and it will go through each of them. And if we find this. Okay, and so for that select issue, I found that I actually forgot to visit a different URL. And we're actually looking for the select element on this URL. So our base URL, and then to golf. So I go ahead and save this, and it'll automatically update on our Cypress. And so let's find this. And what I'll do is we will go up to accessibility right here. We'll go back to accessibility. And we'll see if it has any issues. And so we see we visit golf, we get the select element. And then what we find is we find some other accessibility issues right here on this page now. Main problem with these accessibility issues is the logs are something that you have to look through very carefully. But this is the general idea, is that you can visit your URL of interest, and then you perform accessibility testing on your URL of interest using this command. But remember that we used inject-axe right here in order to inject our and begin our URL, our axe testing, accessibility testing for each of them. But that's this video. I hope you found this video helpful. Please subscribe to our channel and like this video for more content. Thank you.